really don't like it. This is the time of day they're not so happy. And you get little messages saying, take me home.
We'll get you another one.
On a play that's called The Counselor's Spectacular.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at this for you.
Oh.
It should be fun.
Remember you told me you like those?
Yeah.
You can make things out of
them. Someone else in my cabin has them too. Guess how much I love you.
Glad you finally got all my letters. Look, and I got this too. And you can keep your cards in here. You want me to open it for you?
No, it's okay. I can open it in my cabin.
Okay. Here, and look.
How? That's so cool.
Your thing's inside.
That is so cool. Mail for William. Yeah, I want to make stuff with you guys.
You want to hear about everything you've been doing.
Well,
you look like you've been using the sunscreen. Are you out of anything?
Yeah, except I got a little burn on my back.
You said so the other day.
How angry.
Did you get somebody to put some stuff on it for you?
Yeah, I put some aloe vera on it.
Oh, I gave you that. Did you use the aloe vera I gave you?
Yeah, yeah.
Good.
A mallard duck.
Neat.
That's nice.
Wings. These are all birds, huh?
Yeah.
Woodpecker, mallard, bat, great horned owl, and a hummingbird.
I missed you guys so much.
We missed you.
We missed you, William.
So tell us about riflery.
I went there today for specialty. It's really fun. There's this Kung Fu Russian there. He teaches us riflery.
Yeah.
And he was once in the army, the Russian army. He's so cool. He could jump as high as me and kick a light bulb on the ceiling.
No.
Yes.
You saw him do that?
John Nichols did.
How is John?
He's great. He's turned into an adolescent though. Really funny though.
What does that mean?
Really funny.
Are his mom and dad here?
Yeah, I think so. Maybe. I don't know.
You know, that's Aunt Pat's sister. And are Chris and Cindy Headland here? Have you seen Charlie?
No.
No?
Yes, I have.
Charlie. Does John know who you are?
Yes.
And Charlie does too, right?
Yeah.
They came and found you, right?
Yeah, and I met John's, is it older brother or younger brother?
Probably younger.
He doesn't have any.
No?
No.
Is it his cousin, Hallett Nickel?
Could be. Oh, he's here too?
Yeah.
Is he going to camp here?
Yeah.
How old is he?
I don't know.
So is John sort of 13?
Mm-hmm.
Neat, you made a mallard.
Well, don't make them all now. Talk to us.
Here.
This thing glows in the dark when you bounce it.
Let me me see. Does it work?
Well, show Daddy. He's good at that.
Here. Let me see.
So, did some of the guys go away someplace with their mom and dad?
Yeah. I also wanted to...
Uh-oh, what's the bell mean?
It means it's time for us to get out of our cabins. But we
went,
went on a trip called Wabi Noden.
Uh-huh.
And we had s'mores and all that stuff. And are we going right away now? Or are we going to be in time for ops?
What's ops?
What's ops?
Ops is when you get to choose which activity you want to go to, and I want to show you guys riflery.
That's what we want to see.
That's what I was hoping you would say.
Should we put these in your cabin? Hi.
Yes.
How are you?
Hi.
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 So, William, what's it like taking care of your stuff? Yeah? Have you learned a lot? Oh, somebody knows how to play chess here.
Yeah, look.
Oh!
There's an arrow in my other
band. Let's see, William. Wow. Show that again. Show that again to me. Do you get to wear that tonight?
Yes. You're going to see me in it.
I think I might wear this one. Is that okay?
Yeah. It looks a little funny, and I thought people were like, wow!
What's wrong with your mom? Okay.
It's kind of weird.
Yeah, gotcha.
You got your own little setup over here? Everything's all set up?
Yeah, magic tricks. Or can I just show you guys? Well, actually, it's going to be kind of...
Yeah, let's go. And then you can show us later.
First off, do you want to go to dramatics or rifling?
You tell us.
Let's go to dramatics because it's only opening first off.
Okay.
And rifling is open second off.
Okay. Okay. How do you know that?
Here's one of the options sheet.
So, William, are you having a good time here? It looks like you're having a great time.
You feel like you belong here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Who are your best friends that you've made so far?
Well, Jay Carroll.
Oh, you're going to introduce us, I hope?
He left a few minutes ago.
With his parents?
He'll be back, right?
Yeah, he'll be back.
Look, see him tonight.
He went with his mom and dad. Where's he from?
He is from, I forget, either, yeah, I think Connecticut.
Uh-huh.
Bless you.
Thank you.
So has it been cold up here, too?
Yeah.
Was last night pretty cold?
Yeah. I put on an extra blanket.
Yeah, do you have enough warm clothes?
Yeah.
You've been warm enough all the time?
So did I pack everything right for you?
Uh-huh.
Oh, good. I'm so glad.
Well, I have to tell you a lot about Wabi Noden.
What's that?
It's the place I went.
Oh, it's the overnight, right? The camping?
Yeah,
went overnight? On a camping trip? Aren't you too little to do that?
No.
No?
Oh, Wabi Noden. Tell me about it.
It was a canoeing trip.
Ooh.
We canoed out to a little place on the beach, and we went there and played the sandcastle with sandcastles and stuff. Then we went over to Wabi Noden. Canoeing was really fun, even though I couldn't paddle because I was sitting on the ground instead of on a bench in the canoe.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
I was sitting with Connor and General Glass.
General Glass?
He is a counselor. I don't know why they call him General Glass. See, they're from Mason Hall where we eat.
Mm-hmm. How's the food?
Great, except today we had uncooked hamburgers and the french fries were cooked a few days ago.
Well, how do you know that?
Well, the french fries were kind of hard and the hamburgers were pink.
Oh.
So I didn't eat any of that.
Oh, so you must be hungry.
No, I'm not hungry. I took the vegetarian
salad.
How are you?
I'm Dodger.
Dodger?
Yeah.
I'm Craig.
Nice to meet you.
Ellen Oxman.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Thank you.
Do I have to make up a scene together?
use this.
Oh, can I use it?
Give that to him.
All right, what are we getting now? Thanks, Josh.
Who wants to use it?
All of you sit down. All of you sit down. Everyone sit down. Wait, can I use one? No, over there. Guys, we're running out of time. We're not going to get to do any of it. Go. Go. Based on the hats and costumes that you have, you're going to each do a scene, okay? A very quick scene, okay? No, leave the stick. Leave the stick down. Come on, we're running out of time. All right, and we're going to start with Beret Boy and Belt Boy.
Andrew. Hi.
Okay, ceasefire. Make the land safe. The land is safe. Remember that for your protections. Bring up lots of grass.
And try filling me into the scope.
Yeah, it won't work.
Try it.
Try and do what through the scope?
Film.
Oh.
Andrew.
You can just do the zoom.
Andrew. Try filling me through this.
You can do the zoom.
Try filming and you zoom in one part so you see it far away.
Right here. You look through this. Ready?
Yep.
And push it the other way to go wide angle.
William, does everybody call each other by their last name here?
Yep.
They do. I like it, Buckley. Hmm?
Yep.
Hmm. Oh, you're very steady the way you hold that. That's excellent. You getting a shot of Gunnar there? Yeah? Get a shot of Gunnar putting all everything in. There you go. Oh, here they come. Wow.
Hold up your thing.
No, it's not fair. Oh, good.
Hold it up. Let me see what I got.
Hold it up. Hold it up.
A 9 plus
3, 4, 5. Oh, good one.
9 plus 4.
What's 9 times 5?
Here, Will. Come over here.
Excellent.
Show me your score.
I got 29.
Oh. Wow.
19. I need a 30. So good.
Looks like you're on your way.
There's the target.
Oh, yeah.
Just the wrong one.
There's a gun.
Can you zoom with that?
Yep.
How much do you need? 40.
There's a special type.
What's night shot?
22.
Good question.
I think it's like, does that thing have like green nightshades?
What's night shot?
This is the light.
Do you know, Craig?
It should have like nightshades where you could have like green.
Oh, so
yeah, I think I think that's in another type of this camera.
I'm Ellen Oxman.
I'm Dennis. Nice to meet you.
Gunner. Nice to meet you.
He's friends with Gunner.
Uh huh.
He lives in the kitchen. Gunner. Hey Gunner, is this an 8 or a 9? Is this an 8 or 9?
Oh, here's the cardinal rule.
Good.
Oh.
9 plus 8.
Hey, sorry.
I'll keep it and send it.
Go over it again.
You get 22.
Again.
Okay, that's enough, you know? You know why? Because we won't really want to watch.
That's it.
Yeah, there we go.
Who is that guy?
Who can be?
Swimming, riflery, and ranger trail. You have to tell me about ranger.
I don't know how to get it to work. It says it's blinking. Oh, it's working. How do I do zoom? Do you know?
It does when you.
Thank you.
Sachem Maskinomo, on this the 13th sun of the Thunder Moon, welcome the braves of the tribes of Agawam to our third council of this season. To start council this night, I would like to announce that marching honors go to the tribe of Wingfoot. How how! Further, let us begin our council with a roll call starting this night. Tribe of Mohawk, Tribal Chief Tyler Murphy.
Station Mohawk report 34 in band, 31 in council.
How how. For the Tribe of Sinawa, Tribal Chief Andy Gildersleeve.
Station Sinawa reports 34 in band, 31 in council.
How how. For the Tribe of Blazing Arrow, Tribal Chief Jake Checkman.
Station Blazing Arrow reports 34 in band, 33 in council.
How how. Wingfoot, Tribal Chief John Hughes.
Station Wingfoot reports 34 in band, 34 in council.
How how. We are at the end of a very, very pleasant week of weather here at Agawam. Following a period of rather unpleasant weather, with near 100 degree temperatures and high humidity. And we may in fact be getting more towards higher temperatures and more humidity as the weekend goes on. So we need to adapt and we need to change and we need to find ways when it's cold to stay warm and when it's warm to stay cold. We've had quite a range of temperatures, as I mentioned, near 100 last week. At the beginning of our very first session, before these Braves came, we had an opening day for Main Idea when it was 48 and raining. So it's been quite a summer so far for weather. But now that we're nearing the sort of the warm cycle again, begin to think of things and help keep us cool. And last, weeks before last in Vespers, when we rededicated Governor Hall, Dave Mason was here and he mentioned the old water bubbler, or the old water cooler, and how it used great big blocks of ice in order to keep the water nice and cool as the summer went on. And when he was young and camp was first getting started, that's exactly how the refrigeration was done. The blocks of ice were put on top of a refrigerator, and as they melted, the cold air that surrounded them would flow down because it was heavier than the warm air and keep the things underneath nice and cold. But ice come from, especially on days like we had last week where it was near 100 degrees. There weren't too many ice cubes anywhere, including the ice machine in our kitchen. And I discovered the secret of that when I was actually about a 10-year-old camper at a different camp. And I discovered our ice house because we used the same technique, at least for our water coolers, big blocks of ice. And I never really knew where the ice came from, but I was grateful for the cooling effect on the drinking water. But in the winter, here on Crescent Lake or many other lakes in the region, cutting blocks of ice was a winter activity in anticipation of the summer heat. Just like cutting cords of wood in the summer was an activity in anticipation of the winter cold. And people would go out with horse-drawn flat sleds, they called sledges. You go out onto the ice was very deep, usually anywhere from maybe 2 to as many as 3 feet deep in a particularly cold winter. And they go through the ice cutting process, where they first start with an auger. And they turn the auger into the ice and bore a nice little hole. Because the next thing they had to get into the ice was a long, thin ice saw. You get in and they cut along one edge, and they turn the other way and cut along another edge, and cut along, and finally get an ice cube cut in the ice. But fortunately, it was still level with the top of the ice, and the only way that you could get at it maybe would be at the corner where the hole was drilled to begin with. But when there's a will, there's a way. They'd have big ice tongs, and someone would stand off to the side and plunk down on the middle of that cube so it would go down. Now, those of you who have played at the waterfront with balls, if you push them underwater, what happens? They come up quite a distance above the surface. So if you go bang on that ice cube and it goes down, it also rises just enough to get caught by the ice tongs, and off comes the first cube. And the rest is less than brain surgery. You can cut those out pretty easily. So they get their sledges all filled up with a ton or so of ice cubes, big blocks of ice, and they bring it up the hill to an ice house. Put it inside a very simple wooden structure, right in the middle of it, with plenty of room on the outside and on the top, because then the next thing they put in would be about a foot or so of sawdust all around the outside and across the top. And of course, it was sitting on the ground, which is a great insulator. And that would stay frozen and ready to be used in the coolers, and the water coolers or the refrigerators, all summer long. And it was really amazing to go up to one of the old ice houses on a 95-degree day in August and open up the door and reach in up to a foot of sawdust. And there in there was a cube of ice, a great big block of ice that had been frozen in the lake the winter before. Take that out and use it whatever way you wanted to pull things off. Very impressive how ice itself and sawdust makes such a great insulator, so it would just not melt for the whole summer. All of the Native Americans that lived in this area had to make ingenious use of the things that were in their environment and were very dependent upon it, and grew to respect the environment a tremendous amount, because everything they had or needed would be drawn from the environment. They did not want in any way to mistreat it. They also realized that if they were working together as a community, that community effort would really go a long way. And every week in camp, our community effort is focused on having good, positive times at camp. And hopefully we can focus at every council fire on summoning the gods of the four winds in order to give us the fire that we need for our community or for our council. I, as your sachem, have the job of summoning those gods this night. Wabi Nun! Shawnee Nun! Hitchy Nun! Kiwin! Bring us fire! Pleasure nearly every week in council to welcome visiting alums who join us for maybe only the council or maybe a couple of days. Their presence is always really welcome here at camp. And our custom is to introduce them at council, have them rise, tell us a little bit about what they've done since their last council here at Agawam. Sometimes those alums sneak in disguise, and they sit in with the staff, even with a maroon shirt on, so that trying to fool Sachem is never a wise thing to do. I would like to introduce to you first Swampy Mike Smith.
Sachem Swampy Mike Smith is a camper here from 88 to 91, and on staff from 93 to 97, with a brief stint to 98. I'm currently living down in Providence, where I just finished my internship year in pediatrics at Hasbro Children's Hospital. Great to be back.
How how?
How how?
Sneaking into the staff section, but not in disguise, somebody who I introduced to you at dinner, Keigo Shimura.
Sachem, I was a camper here from 94 to 96. Doing that 5 years, I've been going to other summer schools studying. Now I'm in summer academy at Southfield Academy, where I regularly attend. I met Kellar Glass, the general there, and then he invited me for a weekend. I'm glad to be back.
How how?
How how?
Over in the visitor section of the stands, the first alum that I happen to see up there in the stands would be coxswain David Moran.
Oh, Sachem, I was a camper in 1965 and a counselor in 1975 and 1977, and we're here to visit our son, Charlie Moran, who's spending his first summer at Agawam. Since my last council, I've been working in New York for the publishers of the Wall Street Journal, and I'm delighted to be here tonight.
How how?
How how?
Keeping things in the Moran family, we also have Doc Peter Moran.
Well, Sachem, I was a camper here from 62 to 64, a counselor from 71 to 73. I'm visiting here with my son, Andrew, who was a camper here last year, and my wife, Heidi, who was a volunteer at Maine ID in 1975. And we're here visiting our son, Ted.
How how.
How how.
Also sitting in the stands, we have Bosun Tom Barnard.
Let's stage him. Put one down. We got a sleeper coming in. Bosun Tommy Barnard from Simsbury, Connecticut. Spent 77 to 1982 as a camper. 84 to 86 as a counselor. And I thought I was dated, but I'm glad you gentlemen are here tonight. And I have two of my four kids, Dougie and Brendan, here. Hopefully future Agawamers, Sinawams. And we are visiting my nephew, Andrew Barnard.
How how.
How how.
Also Ranger, Jim Carroll.
Sachem, I was a counselor here from 1981 to 1983, and we live in the Washington, D.C. area, and my wife, Mary Beth, and I are here visiting our son, Jay, his first year at Agawam.
How how.
How how.
I don't believe I've missed any alums, but if I have, I apologize. Is there an alum in the stands who I've not recognized? How how.
How how.
Each week, the Agawam staff, among many other things that they do here, keep their eyes peeled for some great acts by the Braves as they live their lives here. And lots of times people do things at Agawam not really thinking anybody's going to notice. So at council, we like to recognize those special acts with commendations. Are there any commendations this night in council? Quarter member Barheit.
Sachem, I'd like to commend the cabin of Princeton for being very well behaved while I was covering them, Brave Atlanta and Persico for numerous acts of unbargaining service, and Brave Jack Mayer for helping me see the joy of being alive.
Braves commended, please rise. How how.
How how.
Doc.
Sachem, I'd like to commend first Brave John Hughes for excellent waiting and putting up with me, and then secondly, the first specialty of windsurfing for being nice to each other and helping me and doing a good job.
And windsurfing Braves and Tribal Chief. How how.
How how.
FM.
For Sachem, I would like to commend Brave Art Snyder for making every meal very enjoyable this week in the dining hall.
Snyder? How how. Bosun.
Sachem, I'd like to commend all of the waiters this week, and especially head waiter Brave McMullen for being exceptionally committed to the details of the job. And I'd also like to commend all the Braves on the Mount Washington One trip, and especially Brave Shuker and Turkovich for exceptional leadership on a very cloudy, rainy, and windy day of hiking.
Waves commended. How, how, and Firekeeper. Dan. How, how? Mike.
I like to commend Brave Edu Maritzia for just an unbelievable job waiting this week.
Brave Maritzia? How, how?
How, how?
Luke.
Sachem. I like to commend the Braves of Florida Crescent 1 for a fabulous trip.
Braves of Florida Crescent 1. How, how?
How, how? How, how?
Commissioner.
Osation, I'd like to commend the Braves of Tour de Crescent number 2.
Braves of Tour de Crescent number 2.
For their sense of adventure.
How, how?
Commander.
Osation, I'd like to commend all the Braves who are on the challenge course this week, especially Brave Hallett Nickel and Brave Hayes and Brave Dunnan and Brave Manrique. And I'd also like to commend Brave Keegan McGowan and Brave Colt for active embarking service.
All Braves commended and fire keepers. Ow, ow. Chip.
Station, I would like to commend Brave Snyder and Brave John Murphy for inspiring them to look their best.
Braves commended? Ow, ow.
Well, Sachem, I'd like to commend Brave Slavinsky for an entertaining as well as excellent job waiting this week.
Brave Kenny Slavinsky. How, how?
How, how?
Ranger.
Well, Sachem, I'd like to commend the Braves of Washington 2 for perseverance in some really nasty weather.
Braves of Washington 2. And Firekeeper. How, how?
How, how?
Interested to hear the trip reports coming up, I think. Ace.
With Sachem, I would like to commend Brave Gregor for building my CQ fire, Brave Slavinsky for making my week awesome, and Brave Goodenough for a wonderful job at tennis specialty.
Braves commended. How, how?
How, how?
Skipper.
With Sachem, I'd like to commend Brave Haugi for showing great fortitude in high winds on Crescent Lake.
Haugi. How, how? Colonel.
Osachem, I'd like to commend Brave Will Wise, who after being blown halfway across the lake on a fishing trip, was able to power the rowboat back with three other Braves in the boat.
Brave Wise. How, how? AJ.
Osachem, I'd like to commend Brave Ian Wright for being awesome down the salmon all week.
Brave Wright. How, how? Major.
Osachem, I would like to commend Braves Nash and Ladika for helping me seek the joy of being alone.
Braves commended. How, how?
How, how?
Swampy.
Osachem, I'd like to commend Brave DeSantis for acts of perseverance on the lake, the high winds, and Brave Will Wads for numerous acts of unbargained service.
Braves DeSantis and Wad. How, how?
How, how?
General.
Osachem, I'd like to commend Brave Mike Sandler for cheerfulness and Firekeeper Ryan for the courage to attempt to make lemonade pasta.
Brave and Firekeeper, how, how? Ensign.
Osachem, I'd like to commend, along with Skipper, all the Braves travel chiefs and Firekeeper of the first racing sailing specialty for working extremely hard and persevering through a lot of different weather conditions and really learning a lot this past 2 weeks.
Braves and Firekeepers and tribal chiefs commended. How, how?
How, how?
There are other commendations. Sparks.
Osachem, I'd like to commend the Brave Japanese for his outstanding sportsmanship and for teaching the Australian Council how to play American football without giving up. And I'd also like to commend Tour de Crescent 3 for their awesome rowing, especially the guys, the Braves, who rowed by themselves.
Brave Near and Tour de Crescent 3. How, how? Colonel.
Osachem, I'd like to commend Brave Dorsk and McMorris for acts of brave.
Morse
and McMorris. How, how? Sarge.
Osagem, I'd like to commend brave Dave Bowman for making me feel like I've been eating at a 5-star restaurant all week long.
Firekeeper Bowman, how, how? Coach.
Osagem, I'd like to commend especially four members of the 11 and under baseball team that played in a tournament at Samoset, playing three games within 5 hours. They are pitchers, Ray Smith Phillips, Keith Rafferty, Michael Anderson, and the catcher, Reed Miller.
Braves commended. How, how?
How, how?
Are there further commendations made?
Osagem, I'd like to commend Braves Shuker and Slavinsky for acts of unbargaining service to another one serving time, like 2 weeks ago.
Belated, Braves. How, how? Brent.
Osagem, I'd like to commend Brave Nick Wall for acts of unbargaining service.
Brave Wall. How, how? Admiral?
Osagem, I would like to commend Braves Reeds and Longley for perseverance down at Smallcraft for the entire week. Also, Braves Dorsk and Farron for wonderful acts of unbargaining service.
Braves commended. How, how?
How, how?
Osagem is well pleased this night with the commendations. The Braves are doing many, many good things. To continue with council, I would like to ask Odom, please take the sand paintings around this week's Great Central Park. Schaefer has described the same paintings, which represent the fourfold laws of woodcraft, which we'll shortly hear recited here in council. Each week we use these 12 laws in order to help make good decisions about the way we live our lives here, and hopefully they'll be taken from Agawam to other parts of the Braves' lives as well. Each week, four members of council recite woodcraft laws for us, and I would like the four Braves who are to recite the woodcraft laws this night to take your places in the gate.
Great Central Choir. I light this, the lamp of beauty. And from it issue these three rays. Be clean, both yourself and the place you live in. Understand and respect your body, for it is the temple of the spirit. Be a friend to all harmless wildlife. Conserve the woods and flowers, and especially be ready to fight wildfires in forest and in town.
Was there any central fire? I light this. The lamp of truth. From it issue these three rays. Word of honor is sacred. Play fair, foul play is treachery. Be reverent, worship the Great Spirit, and respect all worship of Him by others.
I like this, the lamp of love. And from it, it's easy to raise. Be kind, do at least one act of unbarking service each day. Be helpful, take care of the work. Be joyful, keep the joy of being alive.
How, how? Agawam has been holding council fire in much the same way since 1925. And we're fortunate enough to have a complete written history of the councils in the form of our tally. At our first council this year, we actually read the tally of the first council in 1925. I would like to ask the tally keeper this night to read the council of last week's council.
On the sixth sun of the Thunder Moon, the Agawam tribe of 2002 held its second council. Since its call to the Braves and his solo on the platform was an incredible performance, as the Lord Sal erupted with applause. The Braves marched in to the beat of Sachem's solo and marched on his way to blazing arrow. Mohawk reported 34 band, 32 in council. Cinnamon reported 34 band, 31 in council. Blazing arrow reported 34 band, 31 in council. Sage then went on to talk about the totem pole. He explained that it was created by the senior club in 1986, but we all know that Sage actually carved it out in one optional at Shaw, and then painted it the next optional at the Shack. Now it was time for the lighting of the fire. After Chief called to the gods of the four winds, each of them agreed the week had been a success. The fire sparked right up. Sage then turned to the bleachers to welcome his new
sighting of a log covered with leeches, which actually turned out to be algae. Has anyone found his glasses yet? Brave Silas Duffy Rio won not face to open up challenges. Cornell's the Shack came in at a very, very close second to Brown's Coca Companion. Amherst edged out Odiakwa in a one-legged chicken fight. M. Sandler defeated P. Phillips in arm wrestling. And W. Watts caught Fitzsimmons and a cat on the back of a fence, which is actually a line contest. Braves called the staff to point away the competition with the word carcinogen. After the Kentucky list was read and the Omaha tribal prayer perfected, the second council of the 2002 season came to a close, and so it goes, and the tally keeper always knows.
We have many activities that give out awards here at camp, but only one activity presents its awards here in council, simply because the knowledge and skills obtained at Ranger Trail are very closely akin to the skills and knowledge of our Native American forebears. I'd like to invite the Ranger Trail staff forward tonight to present their awards for this week. I know what all the visitors to council are thinking. You're thinking that they choose us to come down here just because we coincidentally happen to be the best looking counselors in camp. I can't explain it. It's just the way that turned out. We have had an awesome week at Ranger Trail this week. Strangely, I wasn't there for most of it. Hopefully that's not sort of a trend, and I'm not sure why that happened. But it was a terrific week, and we actually do have some awards to give out. But first, what I would like to do for the sake of the people visiting is give a very brief synopsis of what our award systems are and what the campers need to attain to get these awards. So, Corp, why don't you give us a brief synopsis of the range partner?
Sure. The partner's the easiest award. It's the first and lowest on the tree. And you can get it in 2 or 3 weeks if you try hard. And it's just no basic flowers, basic knife and axe safety, and know how to build a fire. And, first of all.
It is an excellent award, too. And then, Brave Guy, Soda Member Glass, could you please enlighten about the Brave Guy?
Brave Guy is the next award up. It's sort of you're on your Padawan phase in training. You gotta do a little more complicated stuff, have to be able to light a wet day fire, that kind of stuff, or you know how to do a wet day fire, and usually takes, if you try really hard, you can do it in 3 weeks, but most people end up doing it over 5, sometimes 2 years, like I did. So, the range guy.
And FF, do you want to give us a brief synopsis of the range?
Sure, I'll make it very brief. The Ranger is obviously the third award. It's a lot tougher. It probably takes, if you're working hard, a summer to a summer and a half to achieve. And it just, you basically have to know a lot more wildflowers. You have to know basically everything about fires and axemanship. And it's just one step short of being an absolute guru.
And to be an absolute guru, we have the senior ranger here, which only very few people in the history of Camp Agawam have ever received. It's really about 3 years of really, really hard work. We do have one senior ranger in camp who's all the way over there at the end. And it's we've got one camper who is Brave Shooker, who is working really hard. And he's literally just a pig hair away. I'm not even sure how long a pig hair is, but it's I'm assuming it's something in about that way, but not that close he is. And really, by the time you attain your senior ranger, you're really a combination of things. I like to think of it just to give you sort of some cultural anchoring, so you know what it is. It's really a cross by the time you get this of Elvis Presley, Evel Knievel, William Shakespeare, and Baryshnikov. And it's really, I'm not even kidding about that. It's absolutely true. And one more thing I'd like to add. During the last council, alumni was visiting named Skipper Nelson, and I really embarrassed her because I kind of called her out and asked her to participate,
and she was here with a special friend who'd never been to council before. And I, of course, asked him to participate, and she obviously was a little embarrassed about that. And I know Swampy is here today. The special friend, Amy, right up there sitting next to him. Yes, he's right there. Now, I'd appreciate, just to, so she's not uncomfortable, please don't stare at her right there. So we actually do have three Braves partners to give away. When we read your award, we would like you to come down, and we will give you a Gethingi, which is one of these, and you may put it on the Gethingi on our balsam fir tree. So, start.
Our first partner is Luke Faust.
My cat. Good job, Luke.
Next award is Chris, I run errands.
Next, we have Blake Alex.
My cabin. And we have two. Well done. We have two campers who were awarded their range guide this week.
Alex Long.
He's worked very hard.
And Kyle Fitzsimmons.
These two guys have been working very hard. We're very proud of both of them. And we actually have a bunch of people who are really close. We've got more people working on their rangers than I can ever, ever remember. And I'd like to take special notice of, you know, Ranger Trail, it's a hard business. And it breaks your heart, it really does. And Chris Rogers is so close to his range guide. I'm gonna say he was 5 wildflowers away. And I wanted to give it to him, but Colonel just wouldn't let me. he's gonna get it next council, but his parents here at this council, and we worked really hard. But I just would like to sort of recognize him for trying really hard. And finally, this tree conveniently covers the fact that my shirt is not tucked in. Unfortunately, when Sachem told staff earlier to tuck in our shirts, he neglected to mention that red belts are not a very good match with a maroon shirt. But I promise that I will work on that with next week. And it's going to be another great week at Ranger Trail, and we anticipate a ton of awards.
Hey. One of the reasons that the Braves here in Agawam work so hard on their Ranger Trail skills is that we offer a lot of opportunities for them to join scouting parties or trips away from camp in order to find out about areas and distant tribes. Last week, we had two rather similar and yet different scouting parties on the Presidential Range in central New Hampshire. I wonder if there are trip reports available for Washington 1 and Washington 2. We'll start with, logically enough, Washington 1. Is there a trip report for Washington 1?
Osachem, yes, there is.
Forward.
Start out with number 10. Well, maybe this isn't quite the best thing, but Mount Washington has supposedly the worst weather in the entire world. Now, they can say that, but of course, you know, places like the top of Mount Everest and stuff, there aren't really any, you know, recording instruments and stuff there.
No feet on the ground? Okay. My mic signal? Ready? Begin. knee tag. Requires a Peruvian knee tag on court. The center line. One contested on either side, facing each other. Do it now. The back line. And yet another. Back line. Can't step over the center. Can't step behind the back line. First brave. Ready? Begin. Good block.
Brave
Reed McCollum. This is a old school stair fest. The competitors start back to back, and old school means set a serious expression. The first one to break it loses the stair fest. Ready? Begin. Who did you say was the winner? Oh, right here.
Please watch your step.
And
What are you looking at?
Invisibility cloak card. This is like one of the best cards.
Yeah. How about swimming, Lee? Can I go?
Yeah.
Okay, look, honey. Put your name on here, okay?
Yes. Okay. And then when I need to use it, I just put it on. Just apply it to there.
Yeah. How have you done with getting your stuff into the bathroom? How do you get, what's the easiest way to do it?
Mm-hmm. What do you mean,
well, let me see you put your sunscreen on. Where is all your sunscreen?
I put some on already.
You did? Let me put some on.
On yourself?
Oh, you have lots of books, don't you?
Yeah. Oh, I got these two.
Good.
In a library.
Good.
They're mine now. And here, you can read my how much I've written in
there. Good. Excellent. Staying with perfectly. Oh, and it's good. This rules. I like Trapper and Striker. But I must.
I like Striker more than Trapper.
That's okay.
Yes. Striker and Trapper, I don't really like Striker. It's a lot of fun.
Good, William. Well, just try and write whenever you can, okay?
Okay.
So, William, who lives in each one of these beds?
Connor, right there. He just called me up here.
Sorry. Then who else? Who lives over here? Trapper?
This is Trapper. This is, who's this again? It's General Swim.
Oh, put on your swimsuit. I want to see you swim.
Okay.
Do it again, William.
Watch out for Mike.
Garth doesn't like that. I read all about it.
I'm kidding. But I don't know how to use my account. How do you?
Well, we'll find out and ask. Now, how many boys are in your cabin? 7, right?
Uh-huh.
And what are all their names?
Kevin, Cujo, Alex, Will, Connor, Mr. Drew, by the way, Jack.
Jack, what's Jack's last name?
Near.
He's the good tennis player, right? And he lives in Bronxville?
Yes.
It's very close to New York. Are his parents here today?
I don't know. Probably not.
Hey, William, where?
Yes. Come with me. I want to show you what I was trying to show you earlier.
Okay, we're not walking these sprinkler though.
We're not. We won't see them. We're sprinkling them.
So the guy who does the crossfit for the CrossFit today, he came up to play the CrossFit instant, huh?
There he is. Boo.
That's what I thought. We cut the lawn today, it looks like.
Don't step on it, or else you get your shoes turned over.
You'll remember to put sunscreen on?
Yeah.
What do you want to show us here, William?
And the bug spray too, right?
Yeah.
Hi, Charlie.
Trying to make sure I can come in. Someone's getting changed.
No mail, huh?
No.
Do you have enough stamps there, William?
Yes.
Here, let me put a little. What do you do after dinner on Sunday nights, William?
Nothing really. I don't know. Oh, there's activities.
Really?
I'm not sure what they mean. Okay, so get me a piece of paper.
William, how did you learn how to make your bed?
They taught me.
Really? Who taught you?
I don't remember.
So, okay, can you put William's picture? William and I have realized we don't know how to do this, but we thought you might.
What?
Put the picture in this. There's one right here of Genevieve and William.
Okay.
There it is.